And Jackie Maddock is at the airport. Jackie, almost $250 million down the drain. So what's going wrong at the Flying Kangaroo?
Good evening, Sandra. Well, the spirit of Australia is in the doldrums. The past 12 months have been the most difficult for Qantas than in the wake of the 9/11 terrorist attacks or even the SARS virus. This is its worst result in 17 years. And for that, it blames competition, fuel prices and industrial disputes. In his toughest year, Alan Joyce took on the union and won. But the victory came at a cost, a $500 million loss.
Our goal is to return it to profit and ensure that it remains Australia's iconic flagship carrier.
In just 12 months, a $250 million profit turned into a $244 million loss, its worst result since 1995. It says the cost of October's industrial dispute, $194 million, is largely to blame.
Decided that the $194 million is the amount this year, this month, this announcement, and only a matter of months ago they were saying it was as little as $76 million.
Jetstar and domestic divisions are going strong, but reviving Qantas International is crucial.
It's the fastest growing industry in the world. Unfortunately, it's the least profitable.
At the five-year plan halfway point, it's reining in spending, cancelling plans to buy new aircraft and seeking out key alliances.
In the next 6 months, a very significant alliance with Emirates, which will bring a lot more choices for Qantas passengers.
There'll be no dividend for long-suffering shareholders and no million-dollar bonus for the airline boss.
The tough year that we've had, the tough year the shareholders have, I didn't think it was appropriate to take the bonus.
Even that decision earns Alan Joyce few points with the Transport Workers Union.
If there's time for a revolt, this is a management to revolt against, because they are revolting.
Now, Qantas has shed 2,800 full-time positions in the past 2 years. It says it looks forward to jobs growth when the transformation is complete, but there's no word yet if any of those positions will be based here in Australia.
OK, Jackie Maddock, thank you.